This program is produced by the volunteers of Teleco Village Broadcasting.
Hi, I'm Ellen Fox, here to host another edition of Highlights and Happenings for the Homeowners Association. I happen to be the HOA president this year, and I'm joined by Marcia Herzog, who's HOA's VP of Technology. Welcome, Marcia.
Thanks, glad to be here.
Good. Today we're going to talk about Teleco Life and what a tremendous value that brings to this village. Marcia, can you please start by telling us what is Teleco Life?
Sure. Teleco Life is a website, and we think of it as the place to be to find out all things that are going on in and around Teleco Village. It's sponsored by the HOA, Computer Users Club, New Villagers, and Stay in TV, and operated by volunteers that are here in the village. So it's a place to go to find out about events and activities and clubs and organizations in and around the village.
Sounds great. Can you elaborate a little bit on some of the benefits, both for organizations and for individuals?
Sure, sure. You know, there's so much to do here in Teleco Village that sometimes, sometimes it can be overwhelming to figure out what's going on or what's going on from clubs or organizations that you're interested in participating in. So the value of Teleco Life is that it's a hub. It's the one place to go to find out all that information. And we get over 1,200 people a week that sign on to Teleco Life.
Great.
And over 6,100 page views per week. So this hub gets a lot of traffic, and that's really the benefit for many of the clubs and organizations, is they can advertise, if you will, on Teleco Life and capture a lot of views from the villagers. And to individuals, it's easy because there's one place to remember to go.
Yes, much better than going to every different club's website to see what is going up. So how would I sign up for Teleco Life the first time?
Well, that's really easy, because if you're a member of HOA, New Villagers, or Computer Users Club, you're already signed up on Teleco Life. And that's because those three clubs use Teleco Life as their membership database. So you don't have to do anything special to sign up if you're a member of those. If you're not a member of one of those clubs, it's easy. You just go to the main screen at www.telecolife.org, and at that point, there's a login screen.
Okay, great. So, but what if somebody is not very computer literate and I need help, either with whatever, but I can't get it to work on my laptop or my phone, or what do I do then?
Yeah. First, I need to give you a couple pieces of background before I answer that question.
Okay.
So a couple tips. The first is, and the most important is, you don't need to sign up or sign on to view the information on Teleco Life.
That's a huge benefit. I can just go look.
You can go look. www.telecolife.org. Everything's available for you to see. So all the clubs that advertise there, all of the events that are promoted there, you can look at. You only need to sign up or sign on if you want to do something in Teleco Life where it needs to know who you are. Like if you want to sign up for an event, it needs to know who's signing up for an event. Or if you want to manage your profile, it needs to know who you are. So that's the first tip. The second tip is that if you do have to sign on, it, like so many other websites, it just uses a username and a password. And the username is typically your email, and your password is only known by you. Either you've set it or you need to go reset it if you've forgotten or don't know your password.
That sounds pretty easy and pretty common to all my other applications, right?
Okay. Yeah, so those are the two basics. Now, if you need help, well, I can answer your question, right? So there's a couple things that you can do. There's a, on the main menu, there's a help menu. And if you click on that, it'll drop down and you can see that there's FAQs or places to say if you forgot your password or forgot your username. It'll give you step-by-step online instructions for how to do that.
Okay.
So if you're computer literate enough that you're comfortable there, you can go in and do that. If you think you know how to log on, but you've just forgotten your username or password, you can click the forgot username or forgot password and it'll email you a link that you can go either see what that is or reset it, again, like many other sites.
Yeah, exactly.
And then if that's not enough, and you just really want to talk to a human because you've gotten in trouble or something, there's a Contact Us button on that same menu and several other places on the site. That'll send an email to info@telecolife.org, and we have several volunteers who monitor that email, and we'll usually respond to you in a day or two to get you the human one-on-one help that you're looking for. So several different ways. Use whatever you're comfortable with to
get
connected.
That's great, yeah, to have that many different options. Because sometimes talking to a human does just make you feel more comfortable.
Yeah.
So you said I can use Teleco Life to sign up for an event.
Mm-hmm.
Can you elaborate on that?
Sure. So HOA, New Villagers and Computer Users Club, allow a sign up on their events online at Teleco Life. So you would just navigate to the calendar. It's a button off of the main menu. And you'll see the information about the event. And if it's available for online sign up, it'll have a button that says register here or something like that. Just click that button and follow the on-screen instructions. The other cool thing is many of those events are available to pay by credit card. And so you can pay for the event right online without dropping a check off to a coordinator or something like that. And there's no additional charge for using your credit card online in Teleco Life.
That's great. So I don't have to remember to drop it off or make another to-do, and I could get airline points if
yes.
I use my credit card.
Yes,
okay,
or whatever,
that's important.
Costco points,
exactly,
which is what
Costco.
I do. Yeah.
Yeah. Do I understand that some organizations are also using Teleco Life to recruit new members?
Oh, yeah. That's one of the reasons we get lots of organizations to join us. As I said, there's just so much to do, and if you're a specialty kind of organization, it's hard to get the top-of-mind attention from villagers. Yes, and every new villager is on Teleco Life, so it's a great source to get to the new people coming into the community.
Oh, that is huge if I'm trying to grow a specialty organization.
Mm-hmm.
Do I have to be an organization that's physically located here within the village?
No. We position it as it's about connecting people in and around the village with the organizations and clubs that they participate in. So a couple of examples. Computer Users Club has members who are not within Teleco Village. There might be Rarity Bay or other places. Those individuals are on Teleco Life to interact with the Computer Users Club. Another example would be St. Thomas, located just outside of the village, but they use their Teleco Life homepage and the calendar to emphasize events, activities, things of interest, particularly to folks in the village. So it's in and around the village.
Okay, so those organizations that aren't yet members probably just want to take note of this
yes.
as another good tool and resource for them. So I heard that multiple POA departments are now joining, and they've got a beginning really strong presence on Teleco Life.
Yeah, POA is a valued participant, and we're glad that they're jumping on board. The rec department has been on board for a couple years now, and you can go see their class schedule online.
Mm-hmm.
So rather
I use that, actually,
good,
yes.
Good, yeah. It's more convenient than picking up the piece of paper at the Wellness Center sometimes, but you can go reference it there. The POA board meetings and all the advisory committee meetings are online, so you can see what dates they are, where they're held, those kinds of things. And the long-range planning committee is going to start posting the results of their 10-year planning process that's been going on for the last year and a half. Later this year, they'll start posting some of those activities, some of those results on Teleco Life. So
that'll be great. So
yeah.
I can go find them if I miss a meeting or one publication or whatever I didn't get the first time.
Yeah, and maybe even, we hope, even be able to ask questions to the Long Range Planning Committee about what did you learn about such and such. So
yeah. Sounds very good.
So the POA is there now, and it'll be expanding further. So
Good.
Yeah.
So I know HOA is really proud of being the original sponsor of Teleco Life and kind of seeing the need and starting it. But can you maybe explain to us a little bit on how it's governed now? And
Sure. HOA, at 3 years ago now?
I think so.
Really saw the need for its memberships to be able to sign up for events online and pay their membership online. So really started the activity in the village, and we wouldn't be where we are without that. But we also knew HOA also was committed from day zero to make sure that this was developed by the village for the village. So it wasn't sponsored
just an HOA tool.
Exactly, one
yes.
organization. So the platinum partners that we call them are the HOA, Computer Users Club, New Villagers, and Stay in TV. And those organizations have members on three levels of governance. The Teleco Life Board, which really sets policy and overall strategic direction for Teleco Life, is done by those four organizations on the board. And then there's a steering committee that works on behalf of the Teleco Life Board, also with members of those four organizations. And they really are the acting strategy development
okay,
for the board.
Sure.
We like to say the board doesn't do anything, they just advise us and the other. And then there's an admin team, which is really the worker bees around it. They're the ones who manage the content and keep the site fresh and active. And they're also members from all four of those clubs and organizations. So it's really brought to us by the village, for the village.
Sounds great. And sounds, I like the three-tier approach to that. That sounds like a good structure. How many organizations, roughly, are now on Teleco Life?
I just checked this morning, and there's 39.
Hey, congratulations.
Thanks.
To the village.
Yeah.
Yes.
And I'm talking to two more tomorrow. So we're growing all the time. But the 39 includes five area churches, so we're really excited about that. There's about 10 service organizations, people like Kiwanis, the library, and those kinds of places.
Okay.
And the other, the 20 or so, the others are clubs, social clubs and organizations.
Okay. From here in the village,
from
generally.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So Teleco Life brings us one calendar where I can see most of what's going on in the village. It is free to me as an individual. I have no extra charge to use my credit card and get either Costco points or airline miles. And I can view what's available whenever I want to. Mm-hmm. I don't necessarily have to be available to go to a meeting or a social. That sounds great. Yeah. What an asset. So can you tell us a little bit about how I could get involved if I wanted to volunteer or be part of the Teleco Life team?
Sure. We have a team of volunteers, particularly people that are interested in managing the content of the site, so posting calendar entries or helping us architect the site so it's continuously alive, it's continually interesting and changes over time, and we call those our admins. You don't have to be computer whiz to do this. This is not a mumbo jumbo kind of job. Teleco Life is built on a platform that's state of the art. It's a web platform, so it's keying stuff into a website, doing that. And it's kind of fun to be involved in something that's so important for the village. So those people that are managing the content, we call our admins. And if you're interested in helping us out in that, you can contact us by emailing us info@telecolife.org or seeing anybody that's on the board of one of our partner clubs, HOA, New Villagers, Computer Users Club, Stay in TV.
It's kind
We'd
of fun.
To
yeah, to know a little bit about what goes on.
How the sausage is made, yeah.
Exactly, behind the scenes a little bit. And then to those Teleco Life volunteers and the admins, from all of us that are benefiting from your efforts, just a huge thank you on behalf of the village to bring Teleco Life into reality for us and make our lives a little easier. Anyone who wants more information, as Marcia mentioned earlier, can find it on www.telecolife.org. You can click on the different organizations' homepages and the calendar of events. And please do remember, HOA is a volunteer organization, so if you're a member, thank you. If you're not, please join us. And lastly, our special thanks to Teleco Village Broadcasting and their amazing crew for the opportunity to talk about Teleco Life. Thanks, Marcia.